Hi, welcome to ESP32 tutorial from RoboJax. My name is Ahmed Shamshiri. I'm presenting this tutorial from Canada. In this tutorial, we're going to learn how we can control up to 32 servo motors using ESP32 without Wi-Fi, just directly connecting it as a microcontroller. You can get the code for this by clicking at the link below the video in the description, which will take you to robojax.com/learn/Arduino. Let's get started with this. I have three versions of this video for PCA9685 16 channel pulse modulation controller that can control LED lights or a servo. I've used it for servo. I have first version 1, which you can control 16 servo motors. I've posted that. And then, because of a lot of requests and different type of control, I created version 2, where you can control motors in different way, all motors together, or few of them, or a different methods. The link for those will be below this video as well. I've created video version 3, where 32 servo motors were controlled using Arduino Uno. And now I'm going to show you how you can control this 32 servo motors using ESP32 Wi-Fi Bluetooth microcontroller. This will act exactly the same as Arduino Uno, except we have to demonstrate that everything works. This demonstration and code is preparation for using Wi-Fi and Bluetooth to control 16 or 32 servo motors. If you're planning to use that, please watch this, because on the next step I'm not going to explain everything. I will just jump directly to the portion where you can control it via Wi-Fi, or in the next video via Bluetooth. To make this video short, I'm not going to explain the module, all the input and output. I'm not going to go through the data sheet, another explanation that I did in the version 1 and version 2 of this video. So please watch those videos. The link is below this video, or just type PCA9685 in the search bar of my channel. In the version 3, I've explained how to prepare two of this module, connect them together, and then prepare. As you can see, I've numbered them here from 0, 1, 2, 3 up to 15 on this side. All of these are connected to the module number 1, and then I have module 1, and then for the module 2 it starts from 16, 17, 18 up to 31, because it starts from 0, so we don't have 32. So 32 servo, 16 in one module, 16 is being controlled by one module and 16 by the other module. And for the wiring, we have only three wires, two for ESP32 to get signal from the module and one ground. So from these, we will have only three wires connected to ESP32. And then I have external power connected to power all these motors. And in total, it's 1.7 ampere. Current for this tiny motor is needed, so your power source must be 5 volts, 2 ampere and higher in order to be able to supply the current for all of these. If you're using different motors, and if you're applying a connecting load that these motors will control the load, then the amount of current will significantly increase, and make sure you have enough power for this. Otherwise, it will the voltage will drop and the system will shut off and restart at the middle of operation. Let me explain the wiring for ESP32, because the rest of the wiring have been explained when I did the video for Arduino. I've connected my power supply, this 5 volts external power supply. When all of these are activated, you will need 1.8 ampere with these tiny servos. So the positive is connected to the first wire on this side, the white, and the black is the negative. Negative is connected on this side, on the left side. The last pin here is the same as V plus, and VCC is the pin that you need 5 volts for this module. Now, external power is connected. To get power, connect a DuPont wire like this. So we will supply 5 volts from this module, from the servo section to the module. Very important. Now this module has power. As you can see, the light is on. And then I have here one black wire connected that to the last pin to the ground and connected to a ground pin of ESP32, wherever you have. Doesn't matter which module you have. They will have multiple GND or grounds. Just find it and connect it. Now I'm connecting these two. Green, I will be connecting it to SDA, and blue to SCL. And SDA and SCL are accordingly on the, from the right. This is SCL, the third and the fourth. SDA will be connected to 21, and this will be connected to 22. On this module, I have 21 and 22. Accordingly, I will insert them. If you have different board that it says G21, G22, then sort like this. We have G21, and then we have the RX, and then TX, and G22. But in this module that I'm using, they are labeled as 21 and 22. Without G, they are side by side. In order to start using ESP32 with Arduino IDE, you need to prepare Arduino IDE for that purpose. You will copy and paste it here. You see it says package ESP32index.json at the end. So once you paste it here, click OK, click OK. This is telling Arduino IDE where to get the board driver. Click on Tools, and then Boards, Board Manager. And here, wait for this to complete at the bottom, this bar graph. And then type here ESP32. You see ESP32 by Espressif Systems. It says installed. In your case, it will not be installed. You will have install button here. Click on it, and it will take maybe a few seconds or a minute. And the installation, once is completed, click close. Now we have to tell Arduino IDE which board you're working with, because the driver is ready. Click on Tool, Boards. This is Arduino IDE which you will usually work, but scroll down until you see a line below that. All of these are ESP32, and ESP32 Rover module is the one that you click and select, and the dot will appear. Now we have to select the port. For that, we have to find out which port we are using. Right click on the start menu, device manager, and you see port. Click on this arrow to collapse it, and mine is using COM port, Silicon Lab. If I disconnect it now, you will see that it will disappear, connecting it back. So this is COM6. Note that, click on tool, port, and you will see COM6 is already selected, and now you can write your program and run it. Ensure that the wiring is done properly, we have to upload this I2C scanner. I will provide you the code. I'm not going to explain it. Just copy and paste it in a new sketch like this, and then upload it. I've already uploaded it. Once you upload it, I've selected the same board, Rover 32. The port is already selected, so ESP32 is selected. Now if I open the serial monitor, this is how it shows. Device found. It will find two devices, because two have been connected here, and the address is 0x40 and 0x41. These are determined by the soldering, the way I have soldered it, so it shows the correct address. Now let me explain the code. This is exact code that I've used for Arduino. You need to download this library. I will provide you the link. Once you download it as a zip file, include it in your, save it as a zip file, and then click on sketch, include library, add.zip library, and then point it to where you have saved the library. For if it was in the PC and the downloads, point it to that and select it and click open. Once that is done, this line means the class is included with this line. And then for each board, we are creating instance of the class as an object, and we call it board 1, board 2. And for each, we will set an address. So we are starting address with 40 and then 41. I have fully explained it. 40 is for board 1, 0x40 and 0x41. This is the hex value for board 2. And throughout the code, we will be referring to board 1 and board 2 here. Define servo minimum, servo maximum. These are the value that our servo is responding to the minimum pulse width. And I've determined these by experiment. I've linked, watch the video version 1. I've shown how to achieve it. And here, this is just a variable that is keeping the servo number inside the code. And we are initializing the serial monitor. And this is just testing a text. Let's make it 32. And then board1.begin, you must do board1 and board2.begin. And also you must set board1, set pulse modulation frequency at 60 Hz. And also for 2, these are done inside the setup. And after that, inside the loop, I've created one for loop. If I delete this, you will know that this is one for loop that goes from 0 to 180 with an increment of 10. So this goes from 0 to 180 degrees, where angle is changing. As long as angle is under 181, the angle will be 0, 10, 20, 40, 60. So every time it goes 10 up to 180. And then I have this loop. This for loop I is 0 up to 16 here, because 16 is on one board and 16 on the other board. So these two boards, we're controlling them together. We say board 1, set pulse width, and then I, this I is referring to the board, which is servo on the board, because the I becomes 0 and then it increments, and then 1, 2, 3 up to 15. So 0 to 15, this I will change. This do not change it. And here, angle to pulse is a function that I will explain. It's at the bottom of the code, and we pass this angle, which is between 0 to 180. So this board and this servo will move to this angle. And on board 1 also, we move the servo, whichever is 0 or 1 or 2 up to 15, will move. So this code will move at the same time the servo with the same number on board 1 and the same number on board 2. This is just for demonstration. You can remove this and use it in your code whatever way you want. For example, if you want to control servo 7, just type 6. And if you want to send it to 120 degrees, just type 120, or use a variable to control it. And then we give it 100 milliseconds, and the loop will continuously take the same action. Now, angle to pulse is a function that I have created it here. It takes the number and it maps it, that number, which is between 0 to 180, and it maps it to servo minimum, servo maximum, which I said I've determined experimentally here. So it will map it, and the result is a pulse which fits between these two values. And then this is also printing it on the screen, and it returns the pulse, the calculated value, which will go here. And here is, I'm testing it now without Wi-Fi, making sure that it works. The power is now disconnected. That everything works fine. I'm now demonstrating it without Wi-Fi, just directly as a regular Arduino type microcontroller. That, as you can see, all 32 are functioning and responding. The next step would be to go and test it via Wi-Fi, and we can control each. Thanks for watching. This was how to control 32 servo motors using ESP32 without Wi-Fi, directly wired. If you learned something and found it useful, please thumb up, as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. If you want to get updates of my upcoming videos, make sure to subscribe. Now, in order to make sure that this works with Wi-Fi, before that I uploaded the code without Wi-Fi, making sure that I have no issue with controlling these servos. As you can see with ESP32, now this is running and connected.